Welcome to the Lippis Report.
Hello, everyone. Hi, I'm Nick Lippis, and thank you for joining me today as I announce the vendors who have chosen to participate in the industry's first 10 gigabit Ethernet data center Ethernet fabric test. Well, a few logistical notes before we start. One, this performance and power consumption test is open to the industry, and there is no cost to the vendor community. Second, the test scripts are IETF, RFC-based, and repeatable. So it's open to the industry, and also the test scripts are open as well. The test will be conducted with ICSIA test equipment, and the test lab is the modern ICSIA iSimCity test facility located in Santa Clara, California. The test will take place during the week of December 6th to the 10th, and we'll announce the test results via live high-definition video, via streaming, just like we're doing now, along with a test report shortly thereafter. Also, just a quick note, we were fully committed for this test by the deadline, which was November 5th, end of day Pacific time. So we have no test spots available and left. So why are we doing this kind of test for the industry? And I firmly believe that the market needs it. The market needs an industry test to provide IT business leaders with independent, credible, and reliable performance and power consumption information so they can make informed decisions as they build out private cloud computing infrastructures and facilities. Now, there are a few major industry trends that are driving this new Ethernet-based network fabric within data centers. And quickly, they are, one, and I think we all know, the number of data centers is basically doing this. We all know that. They're increasing. The second thing, what's going on within the data centers is pretty significant in terms of how they've changed. They're getting more densely packed with servers, and virtualization's ability to support more software on server hardware increases their density still. These dense data centers scale up to support unprecedented information demand, I think as we all saw during the economic crisis of 2008. While the financial markets were doing this, information demand and growth was doing that. And it doesn't stop, it's unabated. Now, the other thing that's pretty significant in the marketplace too is that websites are now dynamic versus static, which means that we're creating overlapping north to south and east to west traffic flows that look like Brownian motion more than ever before in our industry. And it's these and other factors that are motivating a new, flatter network fabric that is high performance, low latency, low power consuming, along with all the resiliency and nonstop features common in the data center environments. Well, to assist the market prepare to scale up their data centers to cloud spec, we are very pleased to announce the following vendors are participating in the industry's first 10 gigabit Ethernet network fabric test. Now, note, there are 14 vendors offering product, and 7 are participating in this test, making this the industry's largest ever. Now, in alphabetical order, the participating vendors are first, alcatel-lucen. I am so happy and so pleased that they're bringing in their brand new OmniSwitch 10,000. So the OmniSwitch 10,000 from alcatel-lucen. Apricia, a Hitachi company, they're bringing in their box core. It's called the 15,000-64XL PSR. Supports 56 10 gigabit Ethernet ports and multi-terabit switching capacity. Arista Networks, with their award-winning 7500 very dense core switch. Blade Network Technologies, which is now an IBM company, so IBM is participating in this test. They're bringing in their top-of-rack switch, which is the G8124E and the G8264. Force 10 Networks is bringing in their top-of-rack switch, which is their S4810, which is a 48 10 gigabit Ethernet top-of-rack switch with either 4 10 gigabits or 1 40 gigabit uplink. Juniper Networks is bringing in their high-end core switch, the EX8200, one of the most dense in the industry. Voltaire, A little Israeli company is bringing in their top-of-rack switch, the 6048, which is also one of the first switches on the market to use a single-chip design from Marvell. Now, clearly, there are both top-of-rack and also core switches in the test. The results will be parsed into these two categories. These products represent some of the best engineering in the industry, and we look forward to testing their performance, their latency, and power consumption. Now also, another quick note, I'd like to just thank LifeSize for the use of the LifeSize Express 220 high-definition video conferencing system and also its LifeSize Video Center for video recording and live video streaming. So thank you all very much. Look forward to seeing you all again with the results in mid to late December. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye now.